Assalamu alaikum developers. Today we are going to talk about onClick function in Android Studio. We'll create just this simple application. On clicking this button, the number of count the button is being pressed is being updated. And when we press the reset button, it goes back to zero. So let's get started. First of all, we will open a simple Android project and go to activityman.xml. I will remove this text view and change the layout from constrained to relative layout. The next thing that I will do here is that I will add a button whose width will be match parent and height will be 80 dp. Next, I will bring my button to the center of my activity and give it left margin of 20 dp and similarly right margin of 20 dp. The next thing that I will do is give some text to my button and it will be click me. I'll give the size to this text 30 sp. The last thing that I will be giving to this button is id and it will be m click button. So now as you can see here that I have created a button here. The next thing that I want in my activity is a text view. So I write here text view whose width will be match parent and height will be 50 dp. The next thing that I will write here is give the text size and it will be 30 sp. Now I want my text view to be right above my click me button. So I will write here above and I will give here id of my click button. So I will write here m click button. Now I will give this text view left margin of 20 dp and similarly right margin of 20 dp. Now I want my text to be right in the center of this text view. So I will write here text alignment center. And the last thing that I will be giving to this text view is an ID and it will be m text view. So now our work in XML file has been done. So we'll go back to mainactivity.java and here we will write button m click button and text view m text view. Now inside onCreate function we will write m click button is equal to find view by id r dot id dot m click button and here we will write m text view is equal to find view by id r dot id dot m text view. Now the next thing that I will do here is create my onClick function. So for that purpose I will write mClickButton.setOnClickListener and inside these brackets I will write new view.onClickListener and it will create an onClick function for us. Now what I want is that whenever I click this button it should display me the number of times the button is being clicked. So for that purpose I will initialize an integer and it will be count. I will set its value to 0. Now inside onClick function I will write count is equal to count plus 1 and next thing that I will do is give this number to my text view. So I will write here m text view dot set text. Now the set text accept argument string only but count is an integer, so we will write here value of count. Now it is showing us an error, so what we will do is we'll just press Alt and Enter and it will include the library for us and this error will be gone. Now let's run our application and check. Now our application has started. So whenever we will press this button, it will display the number of times this button is being pressed. So our application is working just fine. So the next thing that we will be adding is a reset button right below this click me button. So for that purpose we will go back to our XML file and copy this button and paste it here. We will change the button ID and it will be m reset button. We will change the text here and it will be reset. Now I want my reset button to be right below my click me button. So for that purpose I will write here below and I will give ID my click button. And now you can see here that my reset button is right below my click me button. So let's get back to activityMain.java. Now again we will initialize the button variable, so it will be mResetButton. And in the onCreate function, we will link this reset button with our XML file. So we'll write here findViewById r.id.mResetButton. Now what we want is that whenever we press the reset button, it should set the count to 0. So we will write here mResetButton.setOnClickListener new view.onClickListener. And inside this onClick function, we will just copy these two lines of code and paste it here. Now on pressing reset button, we want count to be 0. So we'll write here 0. And the next line will remain same. So now let's run our application and test it. So now as you can see here that our application has started. And when we press this button, it starts a count of the number of times this button is being pressed. And when we press the reset button, it sets the count to 0. So this is how you implement onClick function on a button.
If this video has helped you even a little bit, then kindly subscribe to the channel and like this video.